Live from Santa Clara, in the heart of Silicon Valley, it's theCUBE, covering Juniper Nextwork 2016, brought to you by Juniper. Now, here are your hosts, John Furrier and Stu Miniman.
Good, okay, we're live here in Silicon Valley, just always live, it's great. Stu Miniman. Stu, we're kicking off Nextwork 2016, Juniper's annual conference, got a great lineup of guests. Juniper is going deep on the network. Obviously, they run the networks, but when you move traffic around, you can see the intrusions, a lot of security conversations, but ultimately, the network is where the action is.
Yeah, John, and I love the kickoff this morning. They had, you know, the inspirational video, and they said, you know, we're looking for customers that want to, you know, push the laws of physics. Their customers don't go out to build networks. They want to build something that's that they can do amazing, and Juniper wants to do that in partnership. So, you know, of course we're going to dig in, we're going to be talking about, you know, we're going to talk routing, there's, you know, all these different components. You know, last year we talked about the disaggregation of hardware and software, but, you know, here we're talking a lot about business outcomes. Reminds me a lot, John, of, you know, some of the IBM shows that we do. We had, you know, a woman from the IBM Watson Group up on the panel this morning, but, you know, some exciting stuff. As you and I know, we've been tracking for a long time, John, the network is where a lot of exciting stuff's happening, and it's great to see it.
Okay, we're here live in Silicon Valley for the Nextwork 2016. I'm John Furrier, Stu Miniman, kicking off the event. Stu, the security is where you're seeing malware, you're seeing the big enterprises, and we heard on the keynote from the Mandy and C founder, Kevin, and talking about how it's not just malware anymore, you've got governments and big companies that have assets that need to be protected. This is not the drive-by shootings, as he said, but this is about big companies who are prepared for security and being manhandled by these safe harbor of attacks out there. I mean, this is a huge problem. How are the networking guys going to solve this?
Yeah, so John, it's not something that, you know, any one product can do on its own. You talked about it's both the network and the endpoints. I need to have security and visibility into what's happening in the data center, wherever my data is. So a lot of times that's now in the cloud. So there's various pieces that we need to look at, and you know, Juniper believes that they have a strong position to be able to, you know, be able to help and drive some of these, because it's no longer just the perimeter. But it's pervasive.
Stu, I got to ask you the kind of the networking question, because we've been covering networking for years, and we always talk about this, the fabric. I'm a network fabric. I'm the internetworking, all this stuff going. Now you got the cloud. The cloud is a forcing function that puts all the pressure back on the data centers, because the data centers are moving to the cloud. You have an on-premise, you have cloud apps going on. It makes networking more peaked in terms of interest, and you have more and more services. So this notion of fabric that's been around for a decade, how has that evolved, Stu? I mean, how are people dealing with network services? You mentioned endpoint to core. Okay, we talked about that last year. What is networks philosophy here this year? What is Juniper talking about?
Yeah, so the great question, John, because it used to be we talked about, you know, is it overlays and underlays and all of these, you know, really, you know, gnarly, you know, protocols that we're talking about in network. And the premise that Rami, the CEO, put out there was one of, he called it digital cohesion. And that's because we're going to have all these services and things are going to tie together. It reminds me a little bit of the conversation, John, we were having at VMworld about interclouding. What Juniper talked about was what they called mega services, pulling all of these pieces together. So not just, you know, what Uber did is take a bunch of things that we knew and put it together in a service, but you think about what's happening in education and healthcare. The way to really disrupt things going forward is to be able to have, you know, visibility and pull data from lots of places, pull services from across there, and if it's no longer just, I mean, I know you love to talk about kind of the in-memory database there, John, but a lot of these services are going to span not just between multiple nodes, but between multiple data centers, and therefore, you know, the weak link has often been the network. So we've got to have good networking. The reason we didn't have the XSPs back in the 90s failed, it was security and networking were the things that fall down. To make cloud successful, I need security and networking to work, and that's why this is the hot space.
You know, when theCUBE started in 2010, Stu, I said to Dave Vellante, storage is sexy, he said storage, and then look what happened. Storage became super sexy. Dell just bought EMC and was seeing flash memory. Now in 2016, networking is sexy again. You're seeing networking where the action is, Stu. So is networking sexy now?
What are you talking about? This is the plumber's convention, right? I mean, come on, John. You know, this is just, you know, I always love, the storage people always looked at networks as, you know, the pipes that travel their data.
Well,
and SDN,
Stu, let's take SDN. SDN, as you mentioned before we came on camera, is pivoting to security because there's action there. There's a lot of action in networking right now. I'm pretty geeky, cool stuff going on,
yeah.
Transformational.
So Cube alum Abner Germanow, who actually used to work at here at Juniper, said SDN means still does nothing. So, you know, the talk of SDN has really gone down over the last couple of years. Security is something...
Well, what's VMware using it for now?
SDN, NSX, well, the number one use case that they're using NSX for is security, John.
Bingo, so my point exactly, yeah. Stu, is the article that went viral from our .dot conference, Splunk conference last week was Bridging the Last Mile for Security and Analytics, where Splunk, a data log analysis company, is now morphing into data analytics on apps, now going into security, into the network. That last mile, this is where the action is.
Come on, John, over 100 million people last year learned that cyber is hot. So, of course, cybersecurity is something, you know, we talk a little bit about of, our guest this morning, Kevin, kind of poo-pooed the fact that this was some just, you know, rogue, you know, person doing it. The statement I think he said is, we don't know, you know, he doesn't know exactly who it is, but it sure looks like the pattern of, you know, Russian hackers and...
On the DNC stuff, on the DNC stuff mentioned on stage. The one question I want to ask you is, what's the impact to customers now? They've done their networking, they have their Juniper boxes, they have their switches, it's been security around for a long time, they've been doing perimeter-based security. What's the beef, what's the action going on for the impact to customers? What are they doing right now?
So Dave Vellante has been looking at this space, you know, quite a bit over the last year, and this is a board level conversation because it's not a question of if you'll be hacked, but when you've been hacked. You know, the average hack has, when by the time you find out about it, it was 200 days since you found out. So, you know, even if you've got your antivirus up to date, the great line from Kevin Mandia was that it's hard to patch a human. So, you know, we know there's people involved, we know there's so many places that people can get in, and you know, it's kind of scary. It's something that companies all need to worry about. There's lots of insurance, there's lots of product they buy, but we live in, people often say that, security is really an oxymoron in itself.
So let's end the segment by understanding what we're going to be talking about today. Obviously, we had a lot of guests coming on here at the Juniper User Conference, experts, talking about what their environment's like, but this digital cohesiveness, if you will, really comes back down to the same old three-legged stool, you know, compute, storage, and networking, Stu. Now, on top of that, I'll see apps. What does it actually mean to be cohesive in this area? What is Juniper putting forth? What is this North Star vision that they're talking about? Can you elaborate more on what that means and how it impacts the classic building blocks of storage, compute, and networking?
Sure, John. So our last guest today is going to be Jonathan Davidson, and he really walked through, it's the Sky ATP, which is the Advanced Threat Protection. Many of the themes we've been hearing for a long time is it's moving very much to software. It's not device or location specific, but a lot of automation built in. A great line I love from Rami that got when I tweeted it out, got a lot of play out there, is that we've been talking about automation for decades. And it's not like this is the first time that Juniper has talked about automation, but it's simple to say it, it's hard to do it. Automation does not mean taking jobs away. Automation means that it's going to free you up to be able to work on things. Oh, by the way, like making sure your security is in better shape, rather than running around pulling cables and the like. And it's not something that's tactical. I need to have that kind of broad view as to how things look. So the Sky ATP is the solution that they have, looking at detection, enforcement, policy, and management. Juniper, want to really dig into here. We've got some of their ecosystem partners, got some really good customers, thought leaders in the space. I mean, Juniper's public company, been around for decades, you know, well trusted in the environment, and it has a decent cloud play, something we talked about last year with them quite a bit, but excited to go through.
Yeah, and I'm interested to find out what they think of the movement to the cloud. Obviously, they will be impacted. The networking stuff changes, certainly the physical aspect of it, but software, still going to be valuable.
Absolutely, even
more. All right,
more.
Stu Miniman here, breaking it down from the Wikibon side. I'm John Furrier with SiliconANGLE theCUBE, live in Silicon Valley for Juniper Networks NextWork 2016. This is their user conference. We're going to be getting all the data and share that with you here on theCUBE. We'll be right back with more live coverage after this short break.